Cuba tengok Umi semua dah ada belum? 18. Seorang lagi. One ada one. Nampak dia tak ada kan? Din, Tengku, tengok Wan tak ada ni. Try message Wan. Okay, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. And a very good morning. Still morning lah kelas eh, right? 11 o'clock, right? Hoping everybody sehat semua after one short holiday yesterday eh. One day off, right? Okay, so today we're going to continue second hour for our tutorial and we are going to proceed and discuss regarding gene mutation. Okay, we complete a question from Umi's group. Okay, after that, we continue with chromosomal mutation. Okay, a bit theory and a few questions we discuss. And next week, again, you are going to, teacher will assign you a few questions, okay, for you to prepare and for you to present and we discuss together about it, right? Okay, so let's start. Allow me to present my slide. Okay, so we continue from what we stopped last Wednesday. Okay, but before that, teacher would like you to sign up your attendance in your class, eh? So, let's sign up your attendance. Okay, so you can scan the QR code. QR code tu has been blocked. Okay, so scan your QR code for your last tutorial for week 11. So next week we're going to move to week 12. Okay, class eh? Okay, have you done class? Okay, so you done now. Group Umi, just get ready. Okay, we proceed with where we stopped baru ni. Okay, so class eh, turn to page. Umi, what page is your question baru ni?
Page 100.
Okay, so it's a page 100, UPS 2005, 2006, am I right? Umi?
Betul, betul.
Okay, jom.
Cakap dengan cikgu.
Yelah, kamu kena present lah.
Gambar tu menunjukkan type of gene mutation. Kat situ ada 5 frame.
Okay, 5 frame eh. The normal DNA. I, San, Se, U. Alright, 5 codon with 5 frame. Okay.
Lepas tu tengok kat frame nombor 4. Dia ada perubahan.
Right eh. So kalau tengok kat sini eh, Umi. Leucine. Okay. amino acid leucine. Coded by codon AAC. Theorinine. It's a TGA, betul? Okay, proline.
GGC.
GGC, guanin-guanin cytosine, glutamic acid.
CTT.
Okay, dua kali ya, CTT. Alright, so this is a normal sequence. Normal polypeptide chain with the normal DNA. Right, ini DNA kan yang cikgu tulis ni kita padam balik. Yang diberi ni DNA, so teacher nak you tulis, teacher nak Umi bacakan the mRNA sequence lah. Okay, so AAC?
Leucine.
No, itu amino acid. This is amino acid.
Huh?
mRNA dia, codon, mRNA codon. AAC, so dia baca?
Oh, okay, saya cikgu.
Baca je lah, you. A, dia akan transcribe S.
RNA, U-U-G.
So, U-U?
G.
G, okay. TGA?
A, C.
A, right, jap. A.
C.
C.
T.
Cikgu cium ni sekarang. Confuse lagi. DNA, gacity, RNA, gacu. Ingat tak? Gacu. Maksudnya apa? Dia tak ada T.
Ada U.
RNA tak ada T. Dia ada U. So, bila dekat DNA is A, siapa dia akan complement with what yang dalam mRNA? Ni kan mRNA you juga ni. Dia tak ada T. Ingat tak ada T. Okay. So GGC?
CCG.
Okay. CCG. Okay. CTT?
GAA.
GAA. Okay, asid glutamik, satu lagi, glutamik asid juga sama.
Sama.
GAA, ingat kelas when DNA is A, RNA mesti U. Okay, ingat A je mesti U. Okay, so again ni kita buat semua hijau lah So A, U, U, G. Okay, ini T, A, C, U. Alright, so this is the mRNA normal sequence. Okay, teacher nak faham tu kelas mRNA normal sequence. Okay, now, tadi Umi cakap frame nombor berapa berlaku changes?
Frame nombor 4.
Okay, codon on frame nombor 4. So, apa changes yang berlaku pada this codon?
Timing jadi adenine yang tengah tu.
Right, so untuk frame nombor 4, codon CAT, normal sepatutnya CTT, am I right? The normal one is CTT, T, okay? Okay, T, Okay, T substitute with A.
A.
Yes, substitute with A. So, what happened for the first, second, third frame, amino acid still masih normal. Betul tak?
Betul.
Okay, masih lagi normal, right. Tapi when it comes to fourth frame, what happened to the fourth frame?
Dah berubah. Glutamik jadi valine.
Okay, so you baca, this is U, masih lagi U, U, G. Okay, A, C, U. Proline jadi?
C, C.
C, C, G. Okay. Glutamik acid sama G, A, A. But when it comes to ni kat sini frame number 4 instead of normal adalah glutamic acid, glutamic acid tapi dah jadi valine. Glutamic acid normal change to valine. Kenapa tukar tu valine? Bacakan dia punya codon yang ubah.
GUA.
Instead of GAA dia jadi GUA. Right? So this is the changes that you can observe from the sequence. Alright. So mari kita jawab soalannya. Okay, soalan pertama, you jawab apa? Tengok jawapan kamu. So jawapan kamu Okay, bacakan soalan. Tahu cikgu show your answer.
State the type of gene mutation. Saya jawab base substitution.
Okay, eh? So kelas eh? Boleh terima kelas? Okay, so the answer is, kalau you all tengok eh, apa ni, past year's question, dia akan keep on repeating the same concept. Okay, kebanyakannya dia suka tanya this apa ni, this question eh, base substitution. Alright.
B1, genetic disorder caused by the gene mutation as shown, sickle cell anemia.
Alright. Okay. So, kenapa sickle cell anemia kat sini, Umi?
Sebab glutamik tu ditukar di valine.
Yes, eh? So, kalau kau tengok sequence ni, masuk ke kelas, eh? Glutamic acid, always remember, amino acid, glutamic, change to valine, memang khas untuk sickle cell anemia. Okay, it's very specific, eh? Okay, next soalan berikutnya. Baca soalan juga, eh? Untuk kawan kamu dapat, eh? Sambil tu.
Kedua, describe the symptom of the affected person. Jawapan dia, the person suffer from physical weakness and fatigue. The person will have organ damage because of insufficient supply of oxygen to the organs.
Okay, so slow sikit, Umi. Laju nak, okay. So, first kali, simptom yang you nampak, kalau dalam nota kita pun dia dah list, eh. Right, those who suffer from this disease, right, those from suffer from this disease, you akan nampak, right, this person insufficient of, person suffer from physical weakness and fatigue, betul, boleh dapat markah, satu markah. Okay, selain pada tu, ini satu point, eh, point kedua, point lain, the person had organ damage, right, organ damage, why organ damage? Because, yes, insufficient supply, eh, because you all dah tahu, sickle cell anemia ni, shape, apa ni, shape of the red blood cell dia lah, sabit, eh, sickle, okay, right, so that's why this erythrocyte unable to transport enough oxygen, so sebab tu dia panggil an insufficient supply of oxygen, okay, organ damage, yeah, boleh juga diterima, right, okay, so done, okay, next, listkan lagi dua jenis gene mutation.
Saya jawab missing mutation and nonsense mutation.
Okay, yang ini kenapa cikgu tak bagi markah kat Umi? Okay, kawan Umi, siapa kawan Umi? Kawan Umi, ini Umi yang dia, cuba kan kawan Umi, siapa lagi? Umu? Kenapa cikgu tak bagi grup kamu, Umu?
Sebab dia nak yang base tu ke cikgu?
Tak, soalan tanya gene mutation. So dalam syllabus, how many type of gene mutation kita belajar? Yang kamu bagi kat cikgu ni ialah dua another type of base mutation. Base substitution. Dia bukan tanya base substitution ni. Eh? Dia tanya list two type of genetic mutation selain pada base substitution. Nah, itu soalan tu nak sebenarnya. Okay. So Umur, apa jawapannya Umur?
Base inversion.
Okay, base
inversion.
Yes. Kamu bagi okay. Semua lagi tiga yang tidak dalam adalah soalan ni. Okay, base inversion. Mesti ada base eh, lagi.
Base insertion. Base deletion.
Deletion. Eh? Satu lagi.
Insertion.
Togash? Togash, base? In?
Cikgu. Insertion.
Yeah. Insertion. Okay, so Umi eh, Umi and your group, tolong jangan salah faham tentang kehendak soalan eh. In this C, dia nak tanya kamu another type of genetic mutation. Bukannya, what is another example of base substitution. Okay, yang ini ialah base substitution. Base substitution ada tiga kan eh? Iaitu missense, nonsense and silent mutation. Okay, so kalau yang ini ialah missense mutation eh? Okay, Okay, nonsense kalau dia ada stop codon tu. Okay, right. So next, alright. For question D, okay, for question D, teacher would like to, okay, for question D, okay, for question D, this is actually chromosomal mutation. So we are going to discuss later next week, right? Okay, and we are going to proceed with our lesson. Okay, today, nanti Umi next week teacher would like Zinglan to continue later with this D part one, okay? Okay, we reserve the question for Zinglan to present, right? Okay, right. Now let's discuss a bit about chromosomal mutation. Okay, so teacher would like to bring up one question in class. So this one for our chromosomal mutation, okay, non-disjunction we're going to discuss next week, okay, because we need quite okay, for non-disjunction ni, kita nak teacher nak nanti nak bincang dengan kamu, okay. So teacher just nak re-size again, right? So there are four type, of chromosomal aberration. So today teacher nak buat aberration dulu. Okay, so basically Monday baru ni teacher dah mention about you to all of you in class. When we learn about chromosomal mutation, okay, when we learn about chromosomal mutation, the most important thing, okay, these are the 10 learning outcomes from chromosomal mutation. Okay, so this morning teacher nak buat sampai number 4. Okay, number 4. Kita try to do until number 4 and a bit. Okay, so yang lain kita akan continue next week. Okay, so today teacher would like you to have to understand atau to able to explain the chromosomal mutation, satu. Yang kedua, teacher nak you able to classify the chromosomal mutation. Okay, number 3, kita akan guna past year's question in order to understand the concept of chromosomal aberration. Right, and number 4, teacher would like you to describe the types of chromosomal aberration. Okay, so like teacher mentioned in class, this is the most important type. Okay, the most important concept yang teacher nak you tahu when we discuss about the chromosomal mutation. Why? Because karyotype display ni lah. Karyotype ni actually visual display of chromosome. Okay, yang you nampak ni macam satu, but actually it's a duplicated chromosome which condense. Right, yang kamu nampak sentromere semua ni. Okay, so karyotype ini again teacher emphasiskan is a picture of chromosome. Okay, kalau kamu ada your own picture, gambar. So chromosome juga ada its own picture where scientists arrange this chromosome in term of number, in term of appearance. Okay, display dia ialah number. So you nampak sini, dia number the chromosome. Okay, so we are diploid. Okay, diploid means one set from your mom and one set from your dad. Right, and kalau kamu nak kat sini kalian, number one dengan, what's the difference between number one and number two? Okay, in term of size. Okay, so in term of size, because kamu tengok kat sini, this chromosome arranged by size, arranged by shape, and arranged by bending pattern. Okay, bending pattern ni means the allele, the gene itself, right? Okay, let's say kalau sini adalah gene mata, capital A. So the same goes to the sister chromatid also A besar. Okay, so partner dia, the homologous chromosome. Okay, katalah dia adalah heterozygous. So okay, A kecil, A kecil. Okay, kelas ini dia susun ikut size, okay? Ikut shape and ikut the bending pattern. Centromere pun mesti sama location dia. Okay, so with that, let's start kelas. Apa itu chromosomal mutation? Okay, teacher nak you lihat kat sini ada dua benda. Okay, changes in chromosome. Okay, changes in chromosome, it can be the structure chromosome itself, and also changes in the number of the chromosome. So number like teacher mention masa Isnin baru ni, it can be banyak set ataupun it can be dua set saja, two set like us, 2N. Okay, two set, tapi two setnya extra satu plus one minus less one minus satu. Okay, tu panggil aneuploidy. Okay, so when there is a changes, of course, it will shown by the characteristic of the particular organism. Okay, right. So bila kita tengok satu soalan ni kelas nanti Zinglan akan present nanti cikgu hari Rabu ni. Okay, yang rest cikgu akan assign nanti soalan. Okay, now let's everybody turn to page your notes on page 107 teacher akan guna soalan tu untuk develop your understanding about chromosomal aberration. Okay, page 107 class please. 105. Soalan dia kat 105 tapi continuity for soalan seterusnya is on 106. Okay, so 106. Okay, so figure 3 shows, apa kelas? Soalan cakap itu, figure 3 shows chromosomal mutation, am I right?
Betul.
Okay, sekejap cikgu. Tuh, kita bincang soalan ini kelas. Okay, figure 3 shows one type of chromosomal mutation. Okay, so first question tanya your understand your apa ni your lesson about apa yang you faham atau define apa itu chromosomal mutation. Okay, our first learning outcomes dalam di bawah chromosomal mutation. So kat soalan tanya chromosomal mutation ni given in the question. Right, so you all boleh nampak kat sini kelas ni before. Okay, before mutation or before changes, before changes panjang long. Okay, after mutation. Jadi, what happen after mutation kelas? It become shortened. Pendek kan? Right, okay. So first question dia tanya, what is chromosome mutation? Meaning question ni nak you define 2 marks. So how to define? Right, the first point is chromosomal number alter. Okay, chromosomal number alteration. And yang kedua is chromosomal aberration ataupun changes in chromosomal structure. Boleh kelas eh? Okay, chromosomal number alteration and chromosomal aberration atau changes in chromosomal structure. Okay, so 1 mark. Right now, bila you tengok kat sini kan, based on this figure 3, okay, which type of mutation is this? Hello, are you okay over there, my class?
Okay, cikgu.
It's okay. Cukup bunga. I can hear a sound tu. Oh, dah ada Wan? Wan dah ada dah?
Ada go. Tadi line okay, tu.
Alright, okay, okay. Alright, so kalau dah ada. Okay, boleh nampak tadi cikgu, cikgu tunjuk di kelas question. Now we are referring to question page 105 Okay, so kelas. Apa yang cikgu tunjuk just now? What type of mutation kelas?
Deletion.
Yes, definitely you are correct, right? So actually yang kita tengok tadi gambar this in this question shows deletion, chromosomal deletion. Okay, so apa keyword dia kelas? Alright, kalau dalam gene mutation, okay, deletion, the keyword is removal, removal. Tapi kalau deletion, remove of nucleotide. Cik ulang lagi sebab tu dipanggil base deletion Tapi beza sikit dalam kromosom, kromosom deletion, chromosomal deletion yang terdelete atau yang di remove atau lost is segment. Please eh, highlight ke dalam nota kamu tu, highlightkan segment. Segment of what? Segment of chromosome. Okay. So this is shown in this diagram before deletion and after deletion. So ada one part eh, deleted eh, apa? This part. Okay. In the middle it was deleted. Okay. After this part deleted. Okay. After deletion. Yang remaining chromosome tadi akan join balik. Okay. This A part. Okay, ni so A, B, C eh. So, area B, segment B is removed. Okay, ataupun deleted eh. But after that, after B is deleted from this chromosome, this structure of chromosome, okay, A, the part A and the part C will join again. Okay, the remaining end of chromosome will join again. And what happened? So, the chromosome structure become shorter. Okay, kelas eh? So, in this soalan ni kelas eh, balik pada soalan. Okay, ini contoh satu lagi gambar rajan eh. Okay, A, B, C and then D, E, F is deleted, eh, remove. So, the point of break off tadi akan join semula eh. They join and become shorter and the segment that carry gene D, E, F was lost. Okay, losing middle section, right? Okay, so ini adalah penyakit yang teacher nak you have you memorize kelas eh. For chromosomal deletion ada two types of penyakit yang selalu ditanya eh, iaitu muscular dystrophy and cry Duchenne. Okay, muscular dystrophy and cry Duchenne. Okay, kenapa cry Duchenne? Okay, person that baby eh born with this disease, eh, this genetic disease syndrome. Okay, this individual will show salah satu sindromnya why this disorder, genetic disorder we call a cry Duchenne because a cry like mewing of distress cat. Eh, aku tak tahu macam nak ajuk eh, kalau meow meow tu meow meow tu normal lah eh. Kalau what tu kalau ya. Yeah.
Macam ni nangis macam kucing eh, distress macam kucing ke tu?
Ya, bunyi kucing yang distress cat. Nanti cikgu rasa Wan pun cuba cari lah Wan eh. Cikgu pun tak pernah lagi experience ke. Okay, kalau miau biasa tak? Kalau miau kucing mengawan lain ni Wan eh. Itu
kucing gatal.
So itu adalah dua contoh kelas eh. So back to our question just now. Okay, so explain. Question want you to explain how mutation figure 3 berlaku. Okay, so how you explain us? Okay, this is the concept of deletion eh, di bawah aberration. Okay, di bawah concept of chromosomal aberration. So you all to list, teacher nak you jot down the answer. Okay, so this figure, this is deletion eh. Right, deletion. So how mutation figure 3 occurs? Because of the changes in the structure of chromosome, or you can also mention because there is a changes in ataupun chromosomal aberration. Okay, a changes in structure of chromosome or chromosomal aberration. Okay, so ini menyebabkan cause the chromosomal deleted eh, okay, deletion of segment or parts of the chromosome. Okay, so that is how you answer this question, eh? Right. Boleh dapat kelas eh, so far? Okay. Remember balik when we learn about gene mutation, base deletion, eh? Okay, kalau during gene mutation di bawah base deletion, okay, the concept that shows is frame shift mutation. Am I right, kelas eh? Frame shift mutation, okay? That is base deletion. But in this case, right class, whatever class eh, tak kira lah gene mutation ke ataupun chromosomal mutation, okay, this mutation, these changes always cause harmful. Okay, so same goes to chromosomal deletion. Soalan tanya juga eh, what harmful effect may be caused if it occurs in meiosis? Okay, meiosis as you all know, you dah belajar chapter 3, okay, is the production of gamete cell. Okay, so when this deletion occur during meiosis, okay, what can you say about the effect eh? Apa kesannya kelas? So kesan dia sangat besar eh. Kalau base deletion also change the apa ni, the protein, the amino acid, okay, and also degraded the protein. So kalau chromosomal deletion pula berlaku during meiosis, right? Meiosis, as you all know, is formation of gamete cell. Okay, formation of gamete cell. So let's say katalah bawah spermatogenesis, okay, di bawah formation of spermatogenesis. Kalau perempuan, oogenesis. So if there is a deletion occur, so what would is the effect? Yes, kamu kena go by gamete pula. Okay, kalau base deletion, frame shift mutation. Jumlah dikelas, Kalau harmful effect to base deletion, kalau berlaku base deletion, okay, we mention as a frame shift mutation. Tapi kalau chromosomal deletion atau chromosomal aberration in term of deletion, chromosomal aberration in term of deletion, okay, kita sebut effect, harmful effect ni ialah pada gamete. Okay, pada gamete, because dia tanya ni kat meiosis, because you all dah belajar chapter 3, meiosis is the process to produce gamete cell. Okay, so gamete will malfunction. Okay, and bila gamete malfunction, that means kalau kita tengok sperm malfunction and ovum malfunction, okay, what will these two gamete cell affected, So apa kesannya? Yes, kesannya of course anak yang terhasil, offspring will be abnormality or disorder. Boleh kelas, Okay, so next, soalan part 2. Okay, ni soalan part 2 ni adalah sebenar soalan general, Right, name two types of mutation that can cause mutation and give example of each type. Oh, this one actually, kamu dah tahu since gene mutation kita dah belajar ni. Okay, number one is physical mutation. So teacher nak you memorize lah kelas, It can be UV ray, X-ray, gamma ray, alpha and beta particles. Okay, atau number two is a chemical mutation. Okay, okay, chemical mutation ni teacher nak you tolong memorize this, colchicin. Colchicin is a very popular chemical mutation. Please, colchicin, because we are going to meet again this colchicin during polyploidy nanti. Okay, colchicin, okay, selain daripada colchicin, ethidium bromide, okay, mustard gas, formaldehyde. Okay, colchicin ni jadikan yang the first one in class, that you must remember about the example of chemical mutagen. Okay, so this is one question asking you about chromosomal chromosomal mutation, Okay, next, teacher nak you turn to page 10, ni 2016-2017, This one is page 2016-2017. Okay, page 108, okay. Page 108, class, Alright, so this question also ask you about chromosomal mutation, okay? So dia tanya again, learning outcomes number one, okay? Learning outcome number one, you must be able to define apa itu chromosomal mutation, okay? Cikgu tunjuk balik kelas, chromosomal mutation, you kena belajar berapa, you kena tahu berapa sah learning outcomes? Ada 10, Okay, there are 10 learning outcomes yang you all kena tahu. Okay, so first you kena able to explain chromosomal mutation. That means you have to define. Second, you have to classify the chromosomal mutation. Okay, and then explain chromosomal aberration in terms of structure. And describe the type chromosomal aberration. So pagi ni ya cikgu nak cover these four dulu kelas, four subtopic. Okay, so tadi first question kita dah buat, contoh diberi ialah chromosomal deletion. Okay, kalau chromosomal deletion, itu tadi contohnya apa kelas? Ulas balik. Sindrom Kai-Duchet dengan muscular dystrophy. Okay. So now kita tengok lagi satu soalan, define chromosomal mutation again, because kat sini only one mark. So it's a changes eh, kelas eh. Keyword changes mesti kena masukkan eh. Okay. Bersebut saja mutation mesti changes. Okay. Changes of what? Changes in chromosomal structure and chromosomal number. Tulis dua-dua kelas eh. Cikgu harap kamu tulis. Walaupun sini one mark, you just write down both. Okay, chromosomal structure and chromosomal number. Okay, then dia tanya kelas eh. State all types of chromosomal aberration. Okay, so aberration ada empat. Apa aberration? Aberration is your apa ni? Defect eh. Defect, okay, ataupun defect of defect structure eh. Defect of chromosomal structure. Aberration eh. Changes of structure. Okay, so ada berapa kelas? Okay, deletion, inversion. Okay, deletion, inversion sama eh kelas eh. Kalau tengok dalam gene mutation pun ada. Okay, gene mutation pun ada. Inversion eh, deletion. Okay, base deletion, base inversion. Okay, cuma untuk kromosom ada dua yang berbeza iaitu translocation and duplication. Ini tak ada dalam gene mutation eh. Okay, gene mutation hanya ada base inversion, base deletion, base substitution, okay, and base insertion. Eh, tetapi kalau kromosom deletion ada, inversion ada sama eh. Tapi dalam kromosom dia ada chromosomal duplication and chromosomal translocation. Okay, next. Di bawah chromosomal mutation, okay, what happened during cell division? Okay, boleh sebut cell division ni kelas eh. Okay, that lead to alteration of chromosome number mutation to occur. Okay, kat sini dah masuk, ini dah sebut dah masuk alteration eh. Soalan C ni dah masuk soal apa ni? Alteration. Okay, so alteration nanti cikgu nak bincang Rabu pun non-disjunction. Di mana nanti Wong dan juga grup-grup nanti cikgu akan bagi soalan eh for you to okay, we discuss together the question regarding alteration. Okay, so like teacher mentioned just now, you must understand what class? You must understand karyotype eh. Okay, karyotype. Okay, like teacher, what is a karyotype? A picture of chromosome. Okay, itu apa ni, a bit of question. So ini nanti kita akan continue. Question number ni kita akan continue Rabu eh, next week eh. Okay, because semua ni kita nak buat apa tu, alteration. Okay. Okay, satu lagi kelas eh, soalan untuk chromosomal aberration. Empat belas dah yang tu cikgu dah bincang, yang ini okay. Okey, kelas eh, muka surat 109. Muka surat 109. Okey, 2019-2020 eh. Itu lagi satu contoh soalan chromosomal aberration. Okey, so question dia lah on page 110 eh. Okay, ini kira letters eh kelas ni, aberration, right? So itu contoh soalan chromosomal aberration juga yang kamu boleh apa ni, buat latihan, okay? Right. So next week, Wednesday, kita akan continue chromosomal alteration. Okay, so untuk A, B, C, D, cikgu consider done lah kelas eh. Aberration ni not much ditanya sangat. Okay, tetapi yang ni, yang E, F, G, H, I, J ni lagi 6 ni. Okay, lagi 6 ni outcomes ini quite popular. Okay, so next week kita akan spend 3 hours eh untuk really understand all the concept of alteration. Okay, so today cikgu tunjukkan balik kelas ni, alteration. Okay, so untuk alteration, konsep dia ialah apa kelas? Changes in. Okay, changes in apa kelas? Hello.
From structure.
Okay, changes in the number. Okay, changes in the number changes in the number of chromosome. Okay, so alteration ni, bersetuju alteration je kelas yang penyebabnya tak lain tak bukan is non-disjunction during meiosis 1 and meiosis 2 meiosis 1 or meiosis 2. Cuba ulas lagi kelas how number of chromosome can be altered. Okay, how number of chromosome can be altered or can be changed. Okay, the number of chromosome can be altered or can be changed because of the non-disjunction that occur during cell division, iaitu meiosis 1 or meiosis 2. Okay, so in for next week, teacher would like you all untuk ready your concept regarding meiosis. Okay, you kena faham konsep meiosis chapter 3. Okay, chapter 3 yang kita dah discuss sebelum ni about meiosis in order to apply in the concept of how number of chromosome can be altered. Okay, because meiosis as you all know ini ialah yang alteration kita, cikgu akan mula alteration ni aneuploidy dulu. Aneuploidy. Okay, apa maksud aneuploidy? Addition or losing one or more chromosome. Okay, one or more number of chromosome. Okay, kan saya aneuploidy ni bukan set yang hilang bukan set yang hilang atau bukan set yang tambah aneuploidy set dia kekal. Aneuploidy ni always 2n. Ingat kelas aneuploidy n n depan Okay, n depan ni sorry cikgu patutnya pakai highlighter. Okay, aneuploidy biasanya diploid Okay, ingat kelas ingat N, ingat diploid. Set dia tetap lagi dua. Aneuploidy, cikgu ulang sekali lagi banyak kali supaya kamu tak confuse ni. Aneuploidy changes in term of dapat extra number of chromosome, bukan set Okay, cuba ulang sekali lagi. Number of chromosome can be altered or can be changed, ada dua jenis. Okay, polyploidy or aneuploidy. Okay, kalau polyploidy, it involve the whole set yang akan sama ada ubah atau kurang. Tapi biasanya bertambah Dia jarang delete. Polyploidy ni banyak banyak set. Sebab tu kamu akan jumpa triploid 3 set, 4 set, 5 set, 6 set, 8 set, 10 set Tapi aneuploidy masih lagi 2 set. What are the 2 set class? Okay, iaitu diploid. Diploid. Aneuploidy masih lagi 2 set. Okay, apa maksud 2 set? Konsep asalnya apply to human being. Okay, diploid 2 set means one from your class, one from your one set from your partner. Okay, partner means your daddy and another set is from your mommy Okay, one set from your mommy. Okay, from your mom from your mom. Okay, so sama jadi kalau manusia 2N equal to 46. So kalau bertambah satu kromosom dia jadi 47 iaitu 2N plus 1. Okay, kalau kurang satu kromosom dia akan jadi 45. That mean 2N tolak 1. Ha, itu maksud kelas aneuploidy. Okay, so ini berlaku masa bila kelas? So next week kita akan discuss mendalam kelas Okay, so you have to prepare a few questions. Nanti juga assign a few questions. Okay, untuk you buat non-disjunction either during meiosis 1 or meiosis 2. And dia boleh berlaku pada autosome kromosom or sex kromosom. So, in order to understand the alteration of a number of kromosome, you all kena faham picture kromosom that is karyotype. So ini yang kita akan discuss next week, dah almost 12. Okay, so kita akan bincang Nazi junction ni thoroughly, cebut dulu hari ni. Okay, Nazi junction ni berlaku because of the mutagen agent. Okay, mutagen agent tadi menyebabkan daughter cell during meiosis spindle fibernya fail to form. Okay, spindle fiber fail to form menyebabkan homologous kromosom tadi fail to separate properly during meiosis 1 or kalau meiosis 2 sister chromatid yang fail to separate properly. Okay, and inilah cikgu kata di harmful effectnya, dia akan effect kepada the gamete cell, spermatogenesis. Okay, kalau spermatogenesis, sperm akan abnormal. Kalau oogenesis, ovum yang akan abnormal. Right, so this is what means of Nazi junction. Half the daughter cell, okay. So kalau konsepnya kelas ni, aneuploidy, cuba ulasi lagi. Okay, aneuploidy still maintain the two set. Aneuploidy, but changes akan menyebabkan sama ada dia dapat plus one or two and minus one. Sorry, two and minus one. So nanti ini akan menghasilkan gamete sama ada it can be N plus 1 or N minus 1. Okay, kalau normal gamete is 23 normal, okay, but abnormal it can be 24 or 22. Okay, for gamete class, so this is what we are going to discuss next week. So teacher nak you all baca juga your notes, right? So that nanti you boleh catch up with the question and explanation. Okay? So this is what teacher sebut kelas, karyotype. You need to understand the picture of chromosome in order to understand the alteration of number. Okay? Alteration of number can be autosome. Teacher sebut di kelas, kat sini boleh berlaku autosome. Okay, the 22 set. 22 set of autosome, meaning 44. Atau it also can be sex chromosome. Kalau lelaki, dua lah, satu X, satu Y. Kalau perempuan, dua-dua X. Okay, so this is what we're going to discuss next week in class, right? So I think that's all for our class today. Back to our, reserve in class, So next week, teacher nak sambung dengan alteration of chromosome. Okay, number of chromosome altered, but we start with aneuploidy dulu. Okay, aneuploidy means still lagi diploid, 2N, tetapi kenapa that 2 set maybe dapat lagi satu extra chromosome or less one chromosome, less one number of chromosome. Okay, so cikgu stop until here, back to our class, S1CP1. Cikgu seorang-seorang kat situ. Ratika, cuba on kamera Ratika. Cuba tengok Ratika. Miss pula Ratika. Senyap je Ratika. Ratika, hello. Okay, Ratika. Oh, Johor. Okay, Johor. Johor tak PKPB kan? Dah masak ke? Ini masak apa? Ratika masak ke? Dengar je tanya.
Saya.
Ah, Ratika.
Tak.
Alright. Okay lah kelas, So I think that's all for our tutorial class today. So next week kita jumpa lagi lecture. Hari Senin teacher akan sambung chapter 8. And then selepas your online practical test. Tutup kamera Ratika. Cikgu baru nak borang dengan Ratika. Okay. Temanlah cikgu dah habis ni, Okay, hujung nanti Selasa teacher akan assign you all dengan video, So nanti we are with groups, and Rabu we continue again our lesson with chromosomal. Apa Ratika? Hai Rabu? Chromosomal? Hari Rabu kita belajar apa nanti kan? Kromosomal? Alteration sebut?
Alternation cikgu. Mute pula.
Alteration. Kromosomal?
Alteration.
Alteration. Okay. Kita akan tengok how the changes that apa ni caused by mutation can alter the number of chromosome in human, okay? And we start with aneuploidy dulu. Alright, so with that, kalau tak ada apa-apa soalan, teacher end our tutorial class today, okay? And hoping we can meet again next week, okay? Class, bye. Thank you, everyone. Enjoy
Terima kasih, cikgu.
Thank you, Jigo.
Okay, bye, Alex. See you, class. Bye.